Let's talk about environments on Vercel and using environment variables. So Vercel is a front-end cloud, and we work with 35 different front-end frameworks. And typically, you're doing some work on your local machine. You then want to verify those changes. And then finally, you want to actually push that code to production. So we're going to walk through all of those different stages, talk about how you can define custom values as environment variables, and talk about some of the configuration options that you might want. Vercel integrates with a bunch of different Git providers, whether it's GitHub or GitLab or Bitbucket. So I've already set up an account and I've already connected to my Git account. And I want to talk through the process of going from local to preview and to our production environment. So in general, it kind of looks something like this. You start on your local machine in your development environment and you're working on some code. So maybe I want to add a new button or I want to change some value. That's going to happen in my local environment on my computer. So I've got this Next.js app here. I'm reading some environment variables and I'm running my local server. So if I go over to my localhost 3000, I see that the Vercel env right here, this value we're reading is development, and then env process.env.mvar, this is undefined. So where are these values being pulled from? We'll have an env local file in my application, and we can see in here we're reading Vercel underscore env, but there isn't anything defined for this env var. So I could do something like this, and we could say it's value. That looks great. It's going to reload here, and now we see our new value come up here. Now, this is on my local machine. I can pull these values down. I can store them on Vercel, but I probably want something different depending on the environment that I'm in. Going back to our Excalidra photo here, when I push up these changes, whether it's through the CLI or it's through merging a PR in my GitHub account, I want to kick off a new build and I want to use these new environment variables, and I'm going to get a unique URL based on those changes. So let's say, for example, here, I call this environment var. So I have some changes here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this from my CLI, but you could also run this by pushing changes to Vercel. So I'm just going to run Vercel, not Vercel dash dash prod. I'm going to kick off a new deployment here. So let me open up this, and we're going to go here, and we see our new deployment that we've kicked off. Now, notice it says this is a preview environment. So this is going to take our code, it's going to build it for preview, and it's going to give us back this unique URL. So we have the branch URL, and then we also have a specific URL for this commit. So you're always able to reference the specific changes that you pushed by this unique commit URL, but also if you're working on a branch, you know, maybe you have an open PR open on GitHub, you can keep pushing changes there and have a single URL that gets referenced and updated over time. But let's say we want to go look at the specific changes on this URL. So we look at this commit URL and I see Vercel env preview environment variable preview. So on my local machine, this said local. Where did these values even come from? Well, inside of Vercel, we have in the settings page, something called environment variables. And I went ahead and defined a couple different environment variables. So up at the top here, you can paste in values. You can specify the environment that you want and then put whatever value you want. So for example, here I have local, I have preview, and then I have prod, which are the values based on the different environments here. And you can see that, you know, I just recently added these. So that's why specifically for this URL, I'm able to see these changes. Now, for example, if I wanted to run Vercel dash dash prod and kick off a production deployment, what we're going to see is that this value is going to be different. So we're going to have a different deployment for production. I can just close out of this. I'll go back to our project. We see all the different deployments here. So we've kicked off a new production deployment, and this is going to pick up a different value for that environment. So rather than seeing your values on your local machine or the values in your preview environment, this is going to pull the values for your production environment. So I would expect to see this value prod being pulled from env underscore var, and we're also seeing these system environment variables get used. So Vercel has an assortment of environment variables you can read from that you don't need to define manually, like that Vercel env. So if I click out on here, we now see the Vercel env is production. So that's this system environment variable. And then we've also defined this custom environment variable, env underscore var, and that is prod. So For a lot of more simple workflows, this use case of kicking off previews, testing in previews, sharing with your team, maybe leaving some comments, maybe integrating with some other tools, having a PR, merging that PR, that all works great. Then you have it go to production and it updates your domains. This works awesome, but you might want a little bit more flexibility. So let's take a look at that. Maybe instead you want to have multiple preview environments. So you still like this workflow of being able to merge your code into your main branch and kick off that deployment for your new production application. But while you're validating with your team, you still want to have multiple variations of what that preview environment looks like. So maybe it's staging.admin.com, or maybe it's something completely different, but let's take a look at what this might look like. So what I've done is back in my environment variables, I've pushed up my code to a new branch called staging. And when I go to this page now, when I have my environment selection, I can choose which specific branch that I want to use for my preview environment. So maybe for EMV underscore var here, I want to say that this is staging. And if I add a bunch of returns here, it's going to say, are you sure you want to do that? Is that intended? It's not intended. I'm going to hit save. And now here we see we're in this preview environment specifically for the staging branch. So this is different here. Now, if we go back, we could, for example, go here. We could kick it off from pushing our branch, or we can kick it off from the CLI. I'll just do it here, for example. So I'm going to run Vercel again and kick off that new deployment. And now I can have different values even within and inside this preview environment. So I could have really any number of custom branches here that can be long-lived. They can have completely different values, all while still inside of this same non-production environment. So we're not assigning the custom domains or that main domain that we want to have for our production branch. So I will take this. Okay, so this completed and we get assigned our URL here for our domain. So let me open this up and we can see that it's on our preview environment on Vercel, but specifically this EMV, this env underscore var is different because we're on our staging branch. Now that workflow might work great for some other people, but what if I want even more customization? Well, you might have something that looks like this. And when I talk to a lot of larger teams or enterprise teams, they usually have a more complex pipeline or a complex workflow. They want to have a staging environment. They want to have a QA environment or a testing environment. And ideally, once they get to these production-like environments, they can have the same deployment, the same build artifact, and they can promote it throughout these different environments. So maybe they start on testing, then they go to Q&A, and then they assign those domains to their production branch. So for example, let's try this out. For our production environment, when I merge code into the main branch, actually, I'm not going to want to assign any custom domains. So I merge in code, you know what? We're gonna wanna make sure that we do some testing or we do some QA first. So back inside of our project, I'm gonna go into our Git settings and down inside of our production branch here, which is main, I'm gonna say, I don't wanna auto assign the custom production domains. So I'm gonna turn this off and I'm gonna hit save. Now it says, okay, just so you know, that means that deployments need to be manually promoted from a staged deployment to a live deployment. So let's do that. So maybe for example, that staging branch that we were working on where we had some changes here, we decide, okay, we're ready. Let's merge this thing into the main branch. Let's get started on doing the next step of testing. So I merge that into the main branch. We can just get rid of the staging branch now. We're done with it. Maybe you actually want to keep it around, but we'll delete it for now for dramatic effect. And we see that a merge happened and we've kicked off this new deployment into our production branch. Now for further dramatic effect, I also went and pushed yet another commit into our main branch where I made some more dramatic changes. I added this to list item, this is new. We can see our line item here in our commits as well as a new deployment so that we can visually see some differences. There weren't any differences on that last one. So now we see we have these two different deployments here. They're in production, but they're staged. So this deployment, starting with the 8, this is the current production deployment where the domains are assigned and we're serving traffic. So over here, this is what this looks like. Notably, it says, does not say this is new. And if I go back to here and I click in on this deployment and I go look at this specific one, we see this is new. So now, whether this is something that you want to take to your QA team or run automated tests on or anything that you want to do here, you can validate that these changes in your production-like environment look correct. And let's say, you know what? This is perfect. This looks exactly like what I want. Great. Well, now from here, we can say, I'm ready to take this and promote it all the way to production fully. So assigning domains. We're in the production environment, but let's also start routing traffic here. So I'm going to hit promote. It says, hey, are you sure you want to assign these domains? Let's just double check everything here. I'm going to say, actually, yes, I do want to take this deployment that I made in my production environment and assign traffic to it as well too. So back over on our URL, I reloaded and we see this is new. Our traffic has been routed to our new deployment that we've promoted to production and assigned traffic to it. Now, this is a more advanced workflow. It doesn't necessarily need to be used by everyone, but for larger teams that want to have more push button deployment or more promotion control over how code get merged into main or all sorts of different customizations, this can be a good option. Last but not least, wanted to also mention you can, of course, use our CLI or our REST API inside of any of your custom CI scripts. Okay, so that wraps up environments on Vercel and using environment variables. We walked through a number of different options from a simple git push and seeing your code live, all the way up to more complex workflows for larger enterprise teams. But the summary is that Vercel is really flexible and we try to meet you where you're at for how you want to take your code and actually get it online for your visitors. So if you want to see more videos like this, talking more about environments, talking more about custom workflows, please let me know in the comments and we'd love to do more. Peace.